Hello, in this short video, we're going to introduce you to the Vonage Contact Center's integration with Salesforce and some of the capabilities, including Omnichannel, Conversation Analyzer, and some of our dynamic routing capabilities. When we integrate into Salesforce, we do so as a managed package, which includes multiple custom objects, visual force pages, a set of reports. It's a very deep and complete offering. Agents will control their phone activity via the contact pad. Agents have the concept and ability to control their agent state or status, and these are fully customizable by the customer. You'll also notice our integration with Omnichannel. So because this agent is in a ready state for voice calls, they're also in a ready state to receive any digital interactions through Salesforce's Omnichannel presence integration. If we change our status in either one of these areas, it will be reflected in the other area as well. So you can see I've gone now to this away state as an agent. And if I make myself ready, we'll see that that goes quickly back. So we're going to leave ourselves in a non-ready state so that when we start to bring interactions in, they'll queue up and you can see some of what occurs when interactions queue. We have a concept of some information available to the agents across the contact pad. This main tab is showing you my login identity, the groups that I'm a member of. Because I'm multi-skilled, I can be in multiple groups. This is a landing number, so agents have the ability to either present phone calls or answer them on a direct dial phone number or directly within the contact pad, and it's very easy for them to change that. I'm going to utilize the contact pad, and I can do so by just checking this box and essentially ignoring the landing number designation. We also have the ability for an agent to see any calls that are queuing, and if we are routing digital interactions, which we will in this demo, you'll see those other interactions also queue up for the same agent groups. So because of that Omnichannel integration, I'm going to launch an email into this queue very quickly. I've got something teed up here, just a little my account is frozen type deal. We'll get that into the support queue. It takes about a minute for the process for email the case to work and then for Salesforce to route that interaction back to us. And so we'll see that appear here in the queue. And then once that gets established, we're going to get some phone calls for this agent to answer. We introduce the concept of an integrated voice response in the call flow. You don't have to do that. We can intelligently just look up into Salesforce and know who the caller is and influence the routing. But we're trying to show the art of the possible by introducing the voice response capabilities. Option one will do an intelligent routing to the owner of the caller record. Option two would open up a Salesforce support case or allow a caller to interact with an already open case. Option three would be to enable self-service. And so we now see that our email has arrived. And I'm going to get a call into the queue. We'll press option one just to route this particular phone call, and we'll see this come into our queue momentarily. So let's get that launched.
You have reached the new voice media demonstration line. To discuss our great new products and services with your account manager, press one. To speak to our award-winning customer excellence team, press two. To access our self-service option, please press 3.
So I'm going to press 1.
We are sorry that you had a negative experience during your last call. We will transfer you to our escalation team.
And I actually got a specialty announcement, which I'll explain momentarily.
All representatives are currently handling calls. Please remain on the line for the next available representative.
So this caller is now listening to music on hold. They have the option to press 1 at any point in time, and they can remove themselves from the queue and receive a callback as soon as the agent becomes available. Or they could press 2 at any point in time, remove themselves from the queue, and leave a voicemail that can be returned. You did hear the announcement that apologized for the negative interaction. What you're going to see when we pop up the record is that this caller had a bad customer satisfaction survey after the last phone call, and we were able to dynamically route to an announcement reflecting that fact. And you'll see the fields that we use when we pop open the contact record. I'm going to make myself ready. We've prioritized the phone calls over emails because of the live nature of that channel. So as soon as I go ready, the phone call will come in, even though it was hit our queue after the email. And we've now popped open the record for the caller, who is, in this case, Jason Newgarden. That's because we did an intelligent lookup on the incoming phone number, and we routed it to the personal queue of the agent who owns that record. Now, the customer satisfaction example was because of this. And what we're going to do after this phone call is take the survey, and we're going to have a positive experience, and we'll flip this back and place a secondary phone call in, and you'll hear that we don't no longer get the apology announcement. We have popped open, in this case, the contact record in the background. We've popped open the account record for the company that Jason works for. I may need some information in either of those records, so that's why we bring them to the agent when we deliver the phone call. We also bring complimentary information to the agent within the contact pad, so I can see the number that that customer dialed as well as the queue it was delivered to. And I can also see that there was a minute and 10 seconds of wait or queuing time for this particular caller. If I happen to have any problems on the line while I'm talking, maybe I've got some static or volume issues, very easy to report those from the contact pad and keep track of those. So maybe I've got some background noise. I just want to report that issue. You can see that the system has gathered that, and I continue to have my conversation with Joseph. Now, as I'm talking with Joseph, we've surfaced this log a call functionality here on the page layout directly. This allows the agent to, capture some direct notes so that the record that we'll write about the phone call is going to be more informative. So maybe this guy had a question about price on a new product that we're coming out with. We have the ability to have a call reason or call disposition code, and these again are all configurable to your definitions. We're always going to save the record to the focus object, and we have this nice capability to also additively save to an additional object within Salesforce. So potentially that product that he was interested in might be a logical association. And we can say, okay, Jason is really interested in our conversation analyzer product. He wants a price. We can save those notes at any point during or after the phone call. You can see that we actually are recording the phone call, and the agent can be given the ability to pause and resume those recordings. That's a configurable permission set that you can control. Now, I did mention that Jason had the bad customer satisfaction survey. If I needed to, I would have the ability to link to that object. And I can see that he took this survey on the 3rd of April and that he was not happy. And that's the most recent interaction he's had with us. If I needed to or wanted to, I could actually open up the survey. This is a very basic survey we do, showing the art of the possible with just two quick questions. But then I could also, with the proper login credentials, I would have access to the call recording and could actually see, where he said that, he had a problem with that particular agent. So he said the agent was untrained and wasn't able to answer any questions. So you can actually get to the actual voice of the customer right within these surveys. So I've referenced that. Hopefully I've done a better job with Jason. I want to get back to his record and to try to help him. Jason, are we all good? Yes, we are. And just before I release the call, I'm going to tell you that we're going to go into this survey. So you'll hear that as this agent releases the call, the caller will be directed into the voice survey, and we'll do that right here.
Thank you for participating in this short survey. Did we resolve your issue effectively the first time? For yes, press 1. For no, press 2.
So I'm going to say yes.
On a scale from 0 to 10, how likely would you be to refer our services to a friend or colleague?
I'll say a 9.
Please leave any comments about your experience today after the tone.
This agent was much better trained and was able to answer all of my detailed questions.
Thank you for your feedback. We hope to speak to you again soon.
So a couple things have happened. We've now written the activity record about that phone call. We've captured that survey activity properly. And we're going to write all of that back into Salesforce. So we can see here the current values. I'm just going to do a quick refresh of the record, and we should pick up the changes because we've written them immediately back into Salesforce. And so now we can see that Jason's a net promoter. He's happy again. And when I call in, which I'm going to do here momentarily, we will see that he gets the routing and does not get the apology message. So let's do that just to tie that out. Okay, we'll hear this momentarily once I get this launched. Go. Close this down too.
You have reached the new voice media demonstration line. To discuss our great new products and services with your account manager.
I'll just fast forward through, press one. And you can see the call is going to pop. Right. And so we pop it open. He doesn't get the apology, and we can now see the net promoter, and we can do our. He's happy. We'll grab an outcome code. We'll just say it was a case update. And so that's how you can really tie in voice of the customer with the routing, making it dynamic, making it realistic. If we go to that post-call survey here, we can see the survey that we took, and it was a positive one. And of course, I could open that up and get right into that call recording if I needed to as an agent. And while I have Jason here on the line, if I needed to consult with one of my managers or another agent, be very easy to do so with the consult button. I put Jason on hold, and I pop open a real-time window that gives me full visibility into all of the call plans I've written into my call center, all of the queues, and most importantly, all of the agents and their current state. So as I go through here, I can either look for agents specifically by spelling their name, or I could scroll through the list and I can find that someone is available. Michael Brousseau, I know Michael could help me with this. I could highlight him, hit dial. I'm not going to dial because he's not expecting a phone call, but we would be connected and this box would then disappear and these soft keys would say conference, transfer, release, and retrieve. And so those are the tools that that agent needs to finalize that phone call. So I'm going to wrap up with Joseph. I'm going to release him. He's not going to take the survey because he's happy. So we can just hang that up. And want to get into just a brief review of the activity records that we write for each and every phone call and the resultant reports and dashboards that you can have within Salesforce. So I'll just take this most recent call that we had. That was the inbound call where he had a product question. It was about the price. We know it was Jason. It was related to this product that we have in our portfolio. And then I get the metadata about the phone call, and I get a link to the call recording with the ability, as I'm listening to that call recording at any point in time, if I notice anything observational, maybe this agent did a great job opening up this call with the customer, I can make that observation. The system will save those comments in the activity record as well as put a marker, visual marker in the call timeline. So I can now use these in any coaching sessions that I have with my agents. So we're going to roll these activity records up into a series of dashboards and reports that will allow you to manage the activity within your center. So here's an example where I have taken one of our baseline reports. I spent about 5 minutes customizing it, and now it brings in all of my team, all of my agents. I've got this nice graph. I can see one of my agents has been very busy making a lot of phone calls and kind of skewing my graph. But I have the ability to focus in on any of the agents by just clicking on their record within the graph. And then what we did was we grouped all of the calls by agent and then added field values so that the report would be informative and actionable for management. And so when I look at this, I can see the line the call is coming in on, whether it's inbound or outbound, if it's a phone call or a digital transaction, what were the outcome that the agent indicated, is it or was it related to anything else within our instance of Salesforce, how long was that call. And if I wanted to further edit, very easy to do so with the inherent reporting capabilities within Salesforce. So maybe I'll add a link to the call recording right in the report itself. And so I can just start to spell out the field that I'm looking for. The wizard will find it. I can quickly add it to my report, rerun that report. And now I've got a dynamic link embedded in the report if I wanted to of that call recording for each and every phone call here. So this is our standard reporting package, and many of our customers will take advantage of our advanced reporting, which brings in an even deeper level of reporting granularity. So in the report advanced reporting package, we have a call summary object that we've created. It's actually an additional activity record for the call that has a lot more information and granularity in it. So I get this visual timeline of what the caller did. This particular call, we can see there were two agents involved. And at some point, there was a conference and a transfer of that caller to that secondary agent. I can see all of the details about the call itself, the agents who were involved, and then, as I said, just much more granularity and segmentation about that phone call so that I can really understand and drill down into any aspect of it. But the advanced reports is also the baseline for our Conversation Analyzer product. Conversation Analyzer allows you to take those recorded phone calls, fully transcribe them, and understand what was spoken between your agents and your callers. And so for this particular phone call, Conversation Analyzer has that overall customer journey. I have the ability to dynamically understand the amount of time my agent may have been talking versus the customer, versus any silence. And if there was any talk over, there'd be a red slice in this pie. Then you have the ability to subject the call to whatever categorizations you want to look for. These are the categories of things we're looking for in our conversations. And I can show the various different subcategories that make these larger buckets. I can also see within the phone call how many times we saw instances of the different things I was looking for. And anytime I did find that, you'll see that it will be aligned, I'm just going to hide this, along this call timeline. I can see the significant calling events. I can see that agent talk path and that caller talk path. I could listen to the call recording from this interface. I could add another supervisory comment if I wanted to. I could download the call recording from here. But most importantly, I get access to the full call transcript. And anytime that there was a match, I'll get the color-coded indicator of what category that was a party to. And that will go all the way down through the entire phone conversation, all the way to the end. And then lastly, when we scroll all the way down to the bottom of this detail record, we have the entire call transcript also deposited here so that you can use this for any other business purpose within your enterprise. So that's a very complete, very detailed call record. Very interesting for one call. What we tend to do is encourage customers to look at the trends within their contact center and leveraging the appropriate type tool, something along the lines of an Einstein Analytics, which is really a great reporting tool to consume or to digest this very complex call record that we've created. So I could look at a sample dashboard. In this particular case, we have a repository of recorded phone calls. We have 608 random phone calls, and they have all different combinations of various attributes of things that we are looking for. Through Einstein Analytics, I can set up a real-time dashboard that will allow me to interrogate that body of calls in real time and start to filter down and look for calls that exhibit not only the specific metadata attributes, what time and date did it come in on, what agent answered it, how long was it, what queue did it go to, but also things in the call. Was this a particularly professional call? Was there a lot of instances of general courtesy within the call? And so I can start to utilize my dashboards to filter down. So here's an example where I might start to look and I'm trying to find some problems on calls I've had. I know they came in on a specific line, the JMF Tech Support Hotline. This is my line that I use. So I can start to filter down and then maybe I want to look for certain categories that may be within those calls. And so I'm having a real problem where I'm not really seeing the right level of general courtesy within these phone calls. So maybe I want to look and find what is being discussed in those phone calls and actually make sure they're doing the proper greeting. So as I start to look for these things within the phone calls, you can see that those 800 calls or 600 calls, which were random, have now been filtered down to 25 calls that are exhibiting the specific things I'm looking for. And maybe if I know the last agent, and maybe I want to look at what call outcome codes may have been used on that. Oh, we don't have that filter built in. But maybe I also know that it was an inbound call. So you can start to see how I can filter down. And then once I do all the filtering, the advanced filtering, I actually get to the phone calls themselves that meet the specific criteria that I've just established. And if I wanted to, I could open those up and review those calls as well. So I hope that gives you a full picture of how we can help in a contact center with Salesforce, how we can create an all-in Salesforce experience for your agents, and how we can really help to drive a better customer experience and a better agent experience. Thanks for watching.